Here at UT, you are part of a tradition which encourages engineers to think big in order that they may pursue the grand adventures that follow. The UT College of Engineering is rich in a tradition of engineering students who, through their pioneering spirit, imagination, and dedication to their school, became early partners in developing the College of Engineering. Their stories continue to demonstrate how dreams are realized. Commit to quality, exercise creativity, band together, contribute to a great cause, and return a good deed. The College of Engineering opened its doors in 1888 with T.U. Taylor as its first faculty member. By the turn of the century, Taylor, now the college's first dean, became well known for drawing an elaborate checkmark on his students' work, a mark reserved for perfect papers. In 1905, Taylor overheard a student exclaim that he had earned a ram's horn. From that christening, the mark evolved to represent a high-quality standard that became a lifetime goal. Today, the ram's horn lives on as an emblem for the college and as an inspiration for students who strive for excellence. On March 31st, 1908, a group of engineering students wanting to cut class thoughtfully considered how to make a holiday of April Fool's Day. After their initial plan failed to materialize, the engineers decided to convene at Jacoby's Beer Garden to develop an alternate plan. There, they saw a wooden statue about 5 feet high, which they proceeded to borrow. The next day, an assembly of engineers gathered in front of the main building. Between classes, Joe H. Gill, the group's leader, presented the statue as their patron saint and traced his ancestry back to the pyramids, the Hanging Gardens of Babylon, and the aqueducts of Rome. The ceremony successfully broke up classes. The success of this scheme ensured his reappearance the following year when he was officially dubbed Alexander Frederick Clare, patron saint of UT engineers. The popularity of Alexander Frederick Clare with engineering students provoked the jealousy of covetous law students who decided to steal him and claim him as their own. Though he was eventually returned, this marked the beginning of many Alec escapades. For decades, Alec remained at the center of a rivalry between law and engineering students, suffering kidnappings, amputations, and even an arrest, followed by a pardon from Governor James E. Ferguson. In 1975, Alec's association with UT engineering students and alumni eventually formalized into Friends of Alec, the College of Engineering's annual giving program. This program was built to support students and scholarships and has grown to reach student organizations and individual departments. Today, what remains of the original wooden statue is stored in a hermetically sealed display in the Engineering Library. As engineering continues to require creative people to design society's future, Alec's inception and endurance remains a lighthearted symbol of innovation and perseverance. By the 1930s, UT engineering students were changing the face of the campus and of campus life. Carl J. Eckhart, a UT engineering graduate, combined his technical skills, a sense of artistry, and a desire to serve to create some great UT traditions. Perhaps most prominently, he supervised the construction of the main building tower and devised a lighting system that would announce UT achievements. Before the end of his 40-year UT career, Eckhart erected the Santa Rita oil rig on campus in 1958, designed and built mesas for each college to use during commencement ceremonies, and, with the help of the Student Engineering Council, helped spearhead student construction of the Taylor Tea Room. Inspired with the idea of building camaraderie among students and faculty, Eckhart and the newly formed Student Engineering Council set about to create a study lounge for engineering students by digging a basement beneath Taylor Hall. Begun in 1952, Operation Gopher eventually included 3,000 students. College alumni joined the effort, donating $27,000, and Professor Eckhart and his crew from UT's physical plant did much of the wiring and plumbing free of charge. The Taylor Tea Room opened on May 13, 1957, and offered engineering students vending machines, study space, and offices for student organizations. Unfortunately, the Taylor Tea Room doesn't exist today, as it was destroyed to create space for the computer science building. However, the spirit and function of the original engineering student lounge lives on and has set a precedent for students, alumni, faculty, staff, and administration to work together successfully. UT engineers like Carl Eckhart and the founders of the Student Engineering Council have shown through example the success of building a better university that comes with service and teamwork. The dreams of these early UT engineers continue to shape us today. Unwittingly or by design, they all use sweat, intelligence, humor, and imagination to advance the College of Engineering. They nurtured a tradition of optimism and creativity. They established a culture of teamwork and high ideals. We invite you to become a part of our culture. We look forward to seeing your own contributions become a part of our traditions as you begin your engineering career at the University of Texas at Austin.